When I was making my Mandalorian armor, there was one part that gave me a lot of trouble, the right thigh armor. This was a tall and thin print, and it wobbled as the print got higher. After a couple failed prints, then a lot of sanding and filling on the only print I got to finish, I knew there had to be a better way to do this. Hey everyone, Danny here with Vader Dad Builds. I wanted to find a solution to prevent tall, thin prints from either wobbling and printing poorly, or falling over and failing. In this video, I'll share a few tips, the solution to fix this problem for good, and the tests that helped me get to that solution. Alright, let's get started. Tip number one, first layer adhesion. If you don't have good adhesion on the first layer, it's much more likely that you'll have issues with your tall print. First, make sure you have a clean build plate by cleaning it with dish soap and water. Then make sure to level the bed, whether it's done manually or as simple as clicking a checkbox. Now it's time for the first test, vertical versus slanted. I want to see how far each will go before falling without changing any other settings. The slanted prints have angled bottoms so that the base is flat on the bed. The slanted print on the Ender 3 failed first, and there goes the bamboo. The vertical print is the only one that didn't fall. With the slanted prints, not only do you have gravity just pulling it down, you also have the print head going across it and adding pressure with nothing below to hold it up. When the print's vertical, you still have the print head adding pressure, but it's just pushing it straight down and it's not going to knock it over. Tip number two, Z-hop settings. Be sure to check that Z-hop is enabled. You can find the setting in Cura under Travel. Make sure that Z-hop when retracted is enabled. You only need it done over printed parts, so click this as well. In slicers like Orca, you will find it in the filament settings. As you can see here, Z-hop raises the print head or it lowers the print bed depending on your printer. It does this when the print head is traveling without printing. If it's not enabled, then the print head may drag across the parts and either move it or knock it down. Let's move on to test number two, using a brim. In this test, I'll compare the original slanted print with another using the same settings, except this time I'm going to add a brim. First, the bamboo. It still failed, but it performed better with the brim. It printed 6 inches tall before failing, as opposed to 4 inches tall without the brim. The part broke away from the brim and it fell over, but there is a setting to help with that. Make sure to set the brim object gap to 0. On the Ender 3, it didn't break away, and it actually printed all the way through. But let me show you what happens on the time lapse. So far, so good. I'll pause it right here. This is the point where the part with no brim falls. Take a look at what happens with the part with the brim at that same point. Unpause. The brim kept it from falling completely, but it didn't hold it in place as the print head pushes the part down. Okay, so it didn't break off, but you can see here how it started to pull away from the print bed, and this is what I get. Let's move on. Tip number three. Orientation for bed slingers. You'll want the longer side of the print to be in the same direction that the bed moves. If you place it in the opposite direction, it's more likely to move or fall. Test number three, adding support. For this test, I make the part 12 inches tall. I want to add a support, but since there's no overhang, the slicer doesn't generate one. So what I did was make my own custom support and I attached it here. Here's the time lapse, but I'll just speed it up so I can go over the result. This test went very well with the support, but once you get to a certain height, the part will still bend. You can really see the issues here at the top. You really need supports attached at multiple points to keep the part from moving. I modified my custom support to save time and material, and I made them in sizes from 1 inch to 12 inches. I figured the best way is just to mimic tree supports. For my final test, I'll reprint the Mandalorian right thigh armor that gave me a lot of trouble before. I will still generate tree supports in the slicer, but you can see if I set it with a 70% overhang angle, it only generates supports at the bottom, and then I'll have issues printing towards the top. If I go the other way and set the overhead angle to 20%, it produces way too many supports that adds to the time and material. This is why I'll combine the generated supports with the 70% angle with my custom tree supports. And yes, you are able to make manual support blocks in the slicer, but I find the solution much easier and you can just place them wherever you like. I'm happy with the setup and I'll start the print. The print's going well, I don't see any issues with it wobbling. I made the tips of the supports very small so it's easy to just snip them off. Well, I'd call this a success. The supports held it in place and there was no issues with the print wobbling. And here's tip number four, print speed. Slowing down the printer does help with print quality, but it's not the solution to this problem. the way I look at it is if you don't fix the problem and just slow down the printer by 50%, it will just take twice as long for the print to fail. Just for fun, I applied my fix and then I sped up the P1S to ludicrous speed. So far, so good. I don't see any signs of wobbling. I'm definitely happy with how this turned out. Since it was properly supported, I was able to speed it up quite a bit and the print turned out great. I hope you enjoyed this video and it helps you with your next tall 3D print. Be sure to download my manual tree supports. I put the link in the description. Please like and subscribe if you want to see more videos like this, and check this out next. Thank you for watching.